Welcome to Arm Animation. Here we'll learn everything about spine. In this video, we'll talk about common mistakes spine animators may do. And at the end of the video, few general tips. If you want something to be covered in this channel, let us know in the comments of any of our videos or subscribe to participate in the selection of the next videos. Before starting, a few words about our sponsors. I'm kidding, we don't have sponsors, but we have a good friend who animated our new logo for us. For free, who does that? If you liked it, go follow her works on Instagram. Oh no, that's our Instagram. Here. Now, are you ready for some beginner content? Let's begin then. Learning spine means also learning 2D animation. Make sure you are daily consuming animation-related resources, apart from spine. And not only animation. I personally learned some tricks by completing 3D rigging course in Blender. Anyway, here are some steps you need to do before you even open spine. Always, always ask developers what version of spine editor you should use, to avoid downgrading your project after hours of work. Also, check with them if you are limited to use any of spine's features, such as constraints or meshes. If you are a freelancer, check the PSD before talking about the price. Sometimes they come with a lot of trouble, such as masks, tons of unnecessary layers that you have to clean up. And don't forget to check the layer blending modes in PSD. Spine only supports 3 additional modes. Here you can see which one corresponds to what Photoshop's blending mode. Straighten bent parts, such as clothes or tails, to achieve better deformation in spine. And I would personally rotate long parts to make sure it is neatly packed. Make them horizontal or vertical. That would save space for VFX sequences. However, if the final output should be rendered as video or sequence, don't bother about it. If one of the legs comes in perspective to achieve a nice posture, go ahead, copy the normal leg so you can use it in walking or running animations. Same works with the hand state. Duplicate and flip them for each side. They might be very handy in animations. Sometimes developers forget to provide the facial emotions. It's up to you to ask for them. Otherwise, animations will look dull. Imagine exaggerated blow with an idle face. Not cool, not at all. And don't rig the face right away, adding constraints for 3D look. Maybe character is not important, or it will be rendered very small on the screen. Adding complex face rig will also complicate animating facial emotions. So ask developers again if they need rigging the face. We have a separate video for face rig, leaving it on the screen and in description. And before leaving Photoshop, when you set the root marker by dragging from its corner, Photoshop saves it per session, meaning that next time you open Photoshop to re-export, you will have to drag marker again to exactly where you placed it initially. So before dragging, set guidelines, which will definitely be there when you reopen PSD file. Now, once you have PSD prepared and know your spine version, let's open it. First thing, create a container for the character, which will serve as a root bone. Do not animate root bone if the character is made for a game. Imagine developers moving your character on the scene by translating the root bone. And all of a sudden, root bone starts to animate. They don't have control over that movement. Thus, things break. Leave root bone alone. Get your own container. Let's continue. Do not create eye key if you don't need them, especially for arms. I see so many rigs with an arm eye key when they don't need them. It really limits rotational motion. However, if you have created eye key, remember, you can turn it on and off in the animation. And when you create eye key for legs, you can select as target already existing feet. Just make sure they are parented outside of the legs. This will give you ability to move and rotate the same bone. Cool, right? We do this all the time. And with those nicely set up eye key, we encourage you to move those feet. Most of the time, character is adjusting weight before doing any noticeable action. So better if you add little steps to balance the weight realistically. Say no to foot anchors. Avoid creating complex rigs. Add as less bones as possible, since each bone takes time to animate. So maybe instead of adding a bone for each hair strand, you can go with one bone or a few. Use shearing and scale to achieve little 3D effect instead of adding more rig layer. You can see it in action on this shield. It is flat, but it works. I avoided rigging it using meshes and constraints, and instead I had time to improve overall animation. Now let's talk about animation. Here are some idles. If you are asked to deliver idle animation, don't do just breathing, please. There are so many things you can add to those idles that will make character interesting. Create basic idle animation, duplicate it several times, and add that interesting part in between so that it doesn't look repetitive. One of animation fundamentals is timing. We strongly encourage you to pay attention on it. It is very easy to fall into the trap to spend hours of work on a fancy rigging, but then deliver boring animation. Here is an example of monotone animation. And this one is with correct timing. Honestly, I am to this day struggling implementing proper timing, but at least I know the theory and its importance. Remember roller coaster? While this functions very well, this one is much interesting. The moment when time slows down, make sure you prepared outstanding poses. Don't slow down on a pose that has overlapping silhouettes such as those. In general, everything moves in curvy path. This is very noticeable for the hip bone, the main driver of your character. Make sure not to move it in straight lines. Separate its axis to offset them. That will give you curvy movements. Finally, there are two spine features that we use all the time. You'll spend much more time animating if you don't use them daily. Posing and ghosting. Both need to be covered in separate videos. For now, my advice would be to give them a try. And few tips as promised. Did you know that reset button for mesh does three different things depending on where you click it? If you click on it in mesh edit mode, all points will be reset to default four corners. If you click it in setup mode, it will only reset the deformation. And finally, if you click it in animation mode, that will reset the mesh to its setup pose, even if you have deformed it in setup mode. And cool part is that you can even select few vertices in animation mode and reset their position. To see more tips on meshes, check the video on the screen. Second tip is about skins. What to do if you have a skinned character but want to remove the skin while leaving current attachments? If I try to delete the skin, all attachments will be deleted. But if we instead select all placeholders and delete them, a magical checkbox appears. Check it to keep the attachments. And if we have multiple skins, while deleting the placeholders, another checkbox appears, which I will leave for you to investigate. Next tip is about changing the length of the bone. We have several options. We can redraw a bone by holding Alt key. We can set the number here. We can drag from the tip with any of transform tools selected. Just wait for the circle to appear. Or we can hold the Alt key and drag from the tip again. This time, it will push all children along its direction. Cool, right? Honestly, I've never used it. And last tip for the timeline. You can copy frames by just dragging them while holding Ctrl and Shift. Yes, as simple as that. That was it. Check this video for more tips and see you in the next video. And yes, subscribe to vote for the next video topic. Bye guys.